Next speaker is serial number 3. Serial number 3, Mohammed Asim. Will you come please and deliver speech?
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala nabiyyihi Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. Honorable judges, respected guests and my dear intellectual. Today, I want to speak something on the topic of Islam answers to the racial problem. I hope you all would cooperate with me. Dear audience, the Islamic concept of inter-human relations, its high ideal of human brotherhood, and the actualization of this ideal in history are in total contrast to the antagonism between the different races of man as preached and practiced by racism. Let me commence by taking you on Hajj, the pilgrimage to Mecca. You will see there are a multitude of men, women and also children from the every corner of the world, black and brown of complexion, yellow and white, Arabs and Iranians, Turks and Malay, Chinese and Africans, black and white, blue and brown are Europeans. All are dressed alike, wearing two white seamless sheets of simple materials, thus eliminating completely all markers of distinction of dress. Here they have come, brethren to brother, sister unto sister, bearing witness to brotherhood, to equality before their Creator. For it is to worship Him, they have heard His call, and their reply is, Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik, here am I, O Allah, here am I. There is none who is thy partner. All praise and blessing belong to thy Lord, for thou art the soul and thou hast no partner. The huge assembly on the parade of Arafat is perhaps the most spectacular symbol of unity as initiated by Islam, and it is equally a symbol of equality of men before Allah. Dear friends, the Quran elucidates Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 2 and 3. كَانَ النَّاسُ أُمَّةً وَاحِدًا. And mankind is not but a single nation. All mankind were guilty of a single pair of parents, yet they had spread to different elements and developed different languages and different shades of complexion. And yet their basic unity remains unaltered. They feel in the same way and are equally under God's care. Whatever their country, whatever their language, whatever the color of their skin, they are recognized as one family. There is one verse in the Holy Quran which not only restates the common origin of man, but explains the division of humanity into nations and tribes too. Surah Hujarat, chapter number 49, verse number 13. O mankind, we created you from a single pair of male and female, and made you into nations and tribes, that ye may know each other, not that ye may despise each other. Verily, the most honored of you in the sight of God is the most righteous of you. And God has promoted and Israel acquainted with all things. The principle of the brotherhood laid down here is based on the broadest foundation. The address here is not to believers, but to men in general, who are told that they are all members of one family, and their divisions into nations and tribes should not lead to estrangement, but to a better knowledge of each other. This verse of the Holy Quran is the answer of Islam to racism, an answer which, as far as the Muslim community is concerned, did not remain a passing observation, but sounded the death knell of racial discrimination in the world of Islam as borne out, not only by the example set by the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, but also by subsequent events in the history of all Muslim nations and by the general attitude of the Muslims until the present day. In consequence of these teachings of Islam and their translation into practice by the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, Such a confusion was brought in the minds and hearts of the Muslims that to them racial differences present no problems at all. My dear intellectual, in spite of the lofty ideals of age of enlightenment and of the French Revolution, the West did not solve the racial problem, nor has it been able to establish racial equality everywhere in its hemisphere. Racism in the shape of apartheid is still allowed to raise its ugly head in South Africa. And racism is certainly not eradicated in the United States. In spite of abolition of slavery that took place some time ago, and in spite of legislation introduced after the Second World War, in the socialist world, Marxism or communism has introduced its own type of racism that may be called ideological racism. My dear intellectual, in my humble opinion, the secret of the success of Islam lies in two decisive factors: the universality of its teaching and the divine section on which the Islamic concept of the brotherhood of mankind is based. Here I conclude my speech. Thank you all for listening to me patiently. Thank you so much and have a nice day.